Hi everybody, welcome back. This is Mr. Campbell from MrCampbellRocks.com with another tutorial. This is an updated tutorial for the Google Meet attendance extension by Alan Cahy. He's working on it all the time. It's awesome that he's updating all the time. He just updated this past week. I have not done a tutorial on this for probably 6 weeks, and there's a lot of new options that we have, and also kind of a dialogue script as you're going through and working on this for the first time. Alan's basically put in a script to walk you through that. So when we type in Google Meet attendance, it's the one with the green check mark. You'll see that I have it right here in Chrome already installed. So I'm gonna kind of walk you through the process, show you what it looks like. There's a lot more options now. You can track when students come into the meet, when students don't come in the meet. The difficult part about this is the Google Meet grid view extension is really funky right now because Google keeps updating Google Meet. So at this point, unless that is working, it's difficult to take attendance for a Google Meet where you have more than 16 students, because you've got to be able to see those students in the dialogue, or not in the dialogue box, but on your screen, in order for the Meet attendance to work, because that's where it grabs the information from to take attendance. So let's jump in right here. We're going to start a Meet, and before we start the meet, there's some settings that we've got to basically go through in the dialog box. And you'll see that the dialog box is right over here in the Google Meet. So before I start, there's some settings that I want to take care of. So the first thing is when we click on the question mark, you can see, I'm going to do that so we don't get an echo. So when we click on the question mark, basically this dialog box that Alan has created is going to walk you through the whole thing so you can take attendance in it. There are some things that you need to do before you start the meet. And when you go to settings, there's some things that you want to click on depending on how you want to track your stuff. So I want to monitor attendance. Basically, that's going to tell me when a student comes into the meet, when they leave the meet, maybe they get disconnected, they jump back in. So it's going to show me portions of the Google Meet conference where they're not there. Okay. Obviously, I want to remove previous meet checks. So if I had a Google Meet prior to this, and I want to auto save as a CSV, which is going to shoot over right to Excel that I can use later. So when we go back, now that we have the settings here, these are the settings that I recommend. These are the ones that Alan recommends. You could obviously do an HTML file if you wanted as well. It's just going to come across as HTML instead of a CSV file. To get back to the question mark here, right, we're going to do this. Let me make sure that my settings are good here so I'm not getting an echo. Once we click on the question mark, you can see it's basically just a dialog box. So take attendance is about recording who is there and well as who is not there. And so what you can actually do is you can create a list of students that should be in your Google Meet. Now, I don't have classes right now. I'm an administrator, so I could take a list of all my teachers or different things like that. But I'm actually just going to create a list when we get there. So you can set up your classes, right? To start a meet, we're going to click Join Now. Now, if I do that, when I click Join Now, it's going to confirm the meet start time. So there's going to be, as soon as I click Start, there's going to be a little basically timestamp, so we'll just do this so you can see. So the meeting started at 10:44 and it's still going, right? It tells us the monitor attendance is selected, so anytime somebody jumps into this meeting, it's going to show me who's there. I've also got the check mark here. One thing that you'll need to do is you need to change your view to the tiled view if it's already not set up to that, or if you have the grid view extension, you'll need to turn that on. Grid view has not been updated for about 3 or 4 weeks. I know that he's working on it because he's been talking about it. That's not Alan, that's somebody else that created the grid view extension. But my class is small enough, right, that I can use with the built-in tiled view. If not, then we need to do the grid view extension and make sure that's installed, right? You can read right there the instructions. So again, this is how we do this, right? So if we go back to settings, again, we want to make sure that these are the settings here. I can get rid of the dialog box here. Now, I can also create classes pre-made with the students that are in those classes. And so if I want to add a new class, test class 2, right, I would hit that. And then I can copy and paste, and I'm just going to type it in. There. What it's going to do is it's going to let me know when those students come into the meet, right? I believe it's going to be, is my name there. Okay. So it'll show you that none of these 5 students are here. Well, I'm going to grab and go over to my other account. I'll turn off this, turn off the camera. We've got to ask to join. And you'll see what happens now is because my name matches, it shows that I am here. It has a little check mark by my name, and it shows that I am here, right? It shows how long the meeting's been going, what time we started, how many of the participants are there. Now, if I wanted to remove a student, I could. If I want to reset the time, I can reset the time of the meeting. This is where I would save the attendance as a CSV file. So what I'm actually going to do is I'm going to go over to my other account. I'm going to jump out of the meeting for 30 seconds or whatever, maybe, and then jump back in and show you what that looks like on the CSV that's saved that Alan has basically created this code for. So when I come over here, I'm going to close this, and you'll notice it still says that I'm here, right? If I delete all the names, there is no undo, so I can't do that. I want to erase some names. I can do that. I can do a quick check here. If I want, I can delete the check mark. So if a student says they have to leave and it's not manually updating, I can delete that. Once again, when I take this over, go over to my other account here. I'm gonna have to ask to leave because I'm, or ask to join because I'm outside of the organization. So I'm gonna click on join now. Try to turn off both of those. Because I already gave permission, you'll see that it joined again. So here we are in the tile view. Now what I'm going to do is I want to export this. So I want to save this as a CSV file. You'll see easier than numbers. So it'll show me when I arrived, when I was there, when I came, when I left, right? So that is how you use, and there's a more detailed tutorial right over on Alan's site. I just wanted to do a run through it with like the instructions that he's put out there to show you again. So if I want to go here, I can see the dialog box, new installation, updating, taking attendance, monitoring who's there, saving the attendance, different languages, getting help, all of that stuff.
Thank you for watching this video all the way till the end. And thank you for what you do for kids on a daily basis. If this video saved you time, energy, and frustration, go ahead and like, subscribe, and share it with your teacher friends. You can subscribe by clicking up here, or you can watch another video either here or here. Again, I love you, I appreciate you, and I'm glad that you're here.